to a more Spanish approach. Again, we talked about the wrist being turned from the elbow, so it is possible to keep the upper arm as still as possible. We've moved some, but we're not going to be moving that arm around a lot. And what we're going to do now is do that rotational exercise from the elbow and use the fingers. You can take the two middle fingers and scoop, or you can start with the little finger and roll one finger at a time, one finger at a time. And I'll show both. We're just going to roll the fingers in, and then we're also going to roll them out the other way. So if we do one finger at a time, it'll be little finger, and then the next finger, and the next finger, and the next finger. That will take a little practice getting used to that. Or you can hold that tennis ball we talked about in the lotus hands. Hold it between your fingers. And just take this seashell, which is a little bit too big. But if I hold something round between my two fingers and my thumb, I can train my hands to stay into that position. So these will be a more spiky hand now than the classic approach, where the hand is more relaxed and more soft. So now we have a little bit more of a fingery feeling. And if we just hold our arms round like this, and we'll start with using the two middle fingers. Bring the two middle fingers in, let the fingers lead, and then the wrist, and then you open the fingers out. Let's bring the fingers in now towards your body, and let the wrist follow, and then press out. Bring those two fingers in towards your body, and then roll them and press them out, and bring them towards the body, and roll them and press them away from you. All the time that I'm keeping the elbows in the rounded position. Try the same thing overhead, and we'll start with the wrists towards each other and a spiky finger. And now we're going to bring the two middle fingers in, roll, and then open them, similar to the way we would make the cup of the lotus or the blossom, and then bring them the other way and press them out. In this case, we can take the arms behind the body for certain effect. Behind the body in a preparatory position, the second position behind the body with a more full lifted chest, and we can take them behind the body when you go up to the fifth position. And we're presenting the body in a more Spanish or flamenco style. So we're going to take the hands now into this wrist-to-wrist position with the more lifted chest. And we'll roll the hands in, and we'll roll the hands out. And then we'll take the arms down into the second position. Now I have a feeling of pressing open the curtains. Instead of this rounded, full classical position, push those curtains back. When you put the arms behind you, be careful that you don't poke through the lower portion of the ribcage. Lift. Place the arms behind you instead of breaking the ribcage. That's difficult to do. You really have to find that control of the lower portion of the ribcage. But we're going to then move our hands through that same articulation and then coming down. So now we'll move from the same positions, first, second, and fifth, and then combinations, and we'll be using the hands in a more Spanish